The present.
In the residence of esteemed Professor Xander Kaplan and his girlfriend Emily, another argument was kicking off.
I don't understand. I thought you liked tulips.
I do. It's just, you get them for me every year, Xander. It's starting to get a little impersonal. I mean, this time you didn't even include a card.
I apologize. I have obviously made an error in judgment.
Do you remember what I did for your birthday? I got you that new Bunsen burner you wanted. I knitted you a pair of woolen socks so your feet wouldn't get cold in the lab. You never make that kind of effort for me. All you do is think about yourself.
That's incorrect. What about emeladium? It took me 9 months to synthesize that element, and I named it after you.
Oh, you were going to synthesize it anyway. You needed it for your secret project. That silver orb thing in your lab. Emeladium wasn't about me. It was about you. I mean, for God's sake, you won't even tell me what it is that it does.
Is there anything I can do to make it up to you?
I don't know. I mean, it's not like you can just go back in time and get me a different present.
Wait there. I'll be right back.
Xander hurried down the hall, crept into his laboratory, and locked the door behind him. His time machine was right where he had left it. He climbed inside the silver orb and flicked on the power switch. His plan was simple. Travel back in time to this morning, find a new gift for Emily, and bring it to the present. But there were a couple of risks. He only had enough emeladium to fuel 5 minutes of time travel. That didn't give him a lot of wiggle room. Wherever he went, he'd have to shop efficiently. Xander was usually a pretty good problem solver. He had, for example, invented a time machine. But quantum physics and nuclear hydraulics were trivial compared to the rigours of gift shopping. He massaged his temples, trying to remember if Emily had dropped any hints lately. He was attempting to recall the name of her favourite perfume when a thought entered his head. Maybe he was thinking too small. His machine could transport him to any time and place in human history. Why go back a few hours when he could go back a few centuries? He closed his eyes and concentrated. There had to be a right answer. Cleopatra's crown? Joan of Arc's sword? A baby dinosaur? He thought back to the night they met. He was finishing his PhD at the time and his lab had closed early because of Easter. He'd stuffed his papers into his briefcase and shuffled through the rain to the 116th Street station. It was 4:05 a.m. and the platform was deserted except for Emily. It had been several days since Xander's last conversation with a human, and when she started to speak to him, he felt the stirrings of a panic attack. But Emily's friendly smile managed somehow to put him at ease. She was awfully cheerful, given her circumstances. Her metro card had expired, she said, and the machines were broken. She'd been stranded for over 20 minutes. Would he be willing to sell her a ride? Xander nodded and watched as she rooted around in her purse for some cash to pay him back. It was a minute or two before it occurred to him that she had given him a chance to be gallant.
You don't have to reimburse me. I'll swipe you in for free.
She thanked him enthusiastically and then, shockingly, wrapped her arms around his torso. Xander wasn't used to physical contact, and although the hug was brief, it caused his entire body to tingle from head to toe. He still felt that way whenever she touched him. This wonderful person had shown up out of nowhere and given him a chance at love. And in return, he'd given her 3 years of misery. He thought about all of his Saturday nights at the lab, ignoring her calls, making excuses. He thought about the way she'd cried when he handed her the tulips. How could he make up for 3 years of romantic ineptitude with a single birthday present? It was the hardest problem he'd ever attempted to solve. But then, as always, the solution came to him. Xander parked his time machine by the 116th Street station and dashed into the subway. It was 3:45 a.m, a little over 3 years in the past. Emily was standing by the turnstile, swiping and re-swiping her expired Metro card. He took a deep breath and approached her.
Let me guess, expired Metro card.
How did you know?
I had a hunch. Come on, I'll swipe you through.
Oh, that's okay. I'll just go to the machine upstairs or...
You better catch this one. The next one won't come for another 20 minutes.
Before she could protest, he took out his Metro card and swiped her through the turnstile. She smiled back at him with confusion.
Well, aren't you coming?
I need to take a different train.
Well, at least let me pay you for the...
That's all right. It's a present.
He was about to turn away when she leaned over the turnstile and hugged him. It was exactly as he remembered it. Her long brown hair brushing softly against his neck, his entire body tingling with warmth.
Thanks.
He tried to say, "You're welcome," but the words got caught in his throat. He waved goodbye as she boarded the train. Then he marched out of the station alone.